stand back and nothing. Nah, just kidding. Hello, I'm Andres Vasquez, and you are at the Life Fight Show.
And I'm Alexis Melquez. The homeroom winner is finally here. Could it be yours?
And have you heard of the Golden Voice? Tune in for the scoop.
All this and how did our Tesla show to do yesterday against high school?
All this and much more.
In about 30 seconds. And now to the news. All of the spirit points are already counted, and now we have the official winner for the homeroom. The champion of the race is Mrs. Burke's homeroom with 130 points. They will receive their prize next week. Congrats to everyone for participating.
That's nice to know. CGSF members will meet today at lunch in room 406. Please bring service hour forms today in room 406 at lunch.
Tonight is College Making It Happen. Packets containing a wealth of information will be given out. This event is open to both 7th and 8th graders. All students must be accompanied by an adult.
I heard about that. Yeah. I think I'm going to go.
I might go.
Ask your English teacher for the latest book order forms. Ms. Espinoza will be ordering books on Fridays. Your order should arrive approximately in 1 week. Enjoy reading.
Remember to stop by the auditorium after school to buy some cheesy goodness and water to help support the science department fundraiser for Astro Camp this year.
Have you ever heard of Ted Williams, the man with the golden voice? Ted is a 53-year-old man who used to be a radio announcer, but he became homeless after using drugs and alcohol. Later, the Columbus Dispatch newspaper posted a voice of him begging for money on the side of the road, using his unique voice. After the video got a lot of views, Ted Williams went on the Today Show. He talked about all of his job offers, including the one from Cleveland Cavaliers. What do you think Ted Williams is doing now? Well, he is now the new voice for the Kraft Macaroni and Cheese commercials.
Now it's time for your daily dispatch. Araceli Hernandez has your fashion of the week.
What's up, Trojans? Today we have our very first boy starring on Tech Stop Trends. Check this out. First we have Ricardo and Bryce. Bryce is wearing a plaid hoodie with light blue ripped skinnies and black and white shoes. Ricardo is wearing a black shirt and black hoodie and dark skinnies and black Converse. Nice match. Next, we have Desiree. She's rocking out a blue shirt, light blue skinnies, and a white jacket and white Toms. And last, we have Serena. She's wearing black skinnies with a plaid shirt. She tops it off with black light booties and cute earrings. Well, that's all for now. We'll see you next week with more stylish outfits.
Those are cute. Taking a look at TEDSOF's calendar, today is a CJSF meeting at lunch in room 406. Cheesy Goodness is going to be sold after school, and College Making It Happen is at 6:30 p.m. And there is no school tomorrow for Student Free Day. And that wraps up the ongoing events. Now let's go to Victoria Lee with the weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning, Alexis. It's the same thing because, like, all this week is, like, the same thing. So it's just constant, and it will be the same next week. Take a look at the map. Now there's only snow around the Great Lakes, and everywhere else it's going to be sunny, and it's going to be mostly sunny with, yeah, and along the West Coast it's going to be just full sunny with low 70s and maybe 60s. And it's still going to be 20s and 30s around the East Coast, so yeah, let's take a look at the fire forecast. It's going to be sunny today, tomorrow, and next Monday. Well, it's going to be kind of cloudy on Sunday and mostly sunny on Saturday with low 70s and high 40s in the morning. Let's bring it over to Tristan with a wet pool.
Jasmine. Hi. How are you?
Good.
That's good. What could you eat the wet pool?
Should students be required to dress out for PE?
Well, enjoy this video.
Do you think Tetzloff students should dress up for PE?
Yeah, it's like, I'm wearing skinny jeans, and that's not good in the sun.
Do you think most people would agree with you?
Yeah, especially if they wear skinny jeans.
Yes, because some of the teachers make you like run a lot and make you really sweaty, so I'd rather be sweaty in other clothes than my cute clothes.
Yes, they should, only because if they don't, they would ruin their own clothes, and everyone would be mad at that.
No, why? Because it takes us too long, we have to get to the PE placement. What would you rather wear? Our regular clothes.
Well, yes and no, because sometimes it's good to dress up because you're ready. But sometimes it's not, because then you get late to class.
Okay. Do you think that most people would agree with you?
Yes.
Yes, because if you're wearing your regular school clothes, then they'll get all sweaty and they'll stink.
Do you think people would have a problem dressing out?
No, I don't think so.
Kind of, but not really.
No, not really.
It depends, like, if they actually change or not.
Do you think the school should supply them for students, or should parents continue to buy them?
I think the school should supply them because we're already paying for a bunch of stuff in the school.
The school should supply them. Parents should still buy them because it'll help the school.
Interesting question. It would be nice if we could provide for all of them, but it doesn't necessarily always work that way. So we'll be working out and thinking about with our staff and leadership in the district about what the best policy is for that.
The school should supply them.
Why?
Because some people can't afford them.
Comments what all of you guys said. We'll hear the results of what you guys had to say. 75% of you guys said yes, 17% said no, and 8% said doesn't matter. Well, we want to hear all your comments, thoughts, and opinions. Be sure to visit us online at lamfastshow.com to vote. Send your comments to the webpool at lamfastshow.com, and if your comments are good, we'll read it on air. So Jasmine, should Tetzloff have vending machines?
Ooh. Yeah.
Because so people won't have to wait in the line.
I agree. Well, thanks, Jasmine.
I'd like to give a shout out to Valerie, Jessica, Julianne, Vanessa, and Bradley.
I'll give a shout out to Saul Campo, Alex Suarez, Araceli Hernandez, and Justin Bayan. Justin Bayan. Okay, well, thanks, Jasmine. Well, that wraps up my time for today. I'm Tristan Chan. You guys have a nice day. See you guys on Monday. Bye. See you, Jimmy.
Smart. That never gets old. But thank you for that web poll, Tristan. Now it's time with sports time with Aaron Brown. How you doing?
I'm doing good. From the North Pole to the South Pole and everything in between, this is Live in 5 Sports. I'm Aaron LaRue Brown. The Houston Rockets handed the Clippers their second straight loss in a row. Griffin produced his lowest point average since December 6th of last year. He scored only 13 points and grabbed 11 rebounds. He also went 5-for-16 from the field and coughed up 3 turnovers. Turnovers. There you go. Not Griffin's best game. And how did our Tetzloff Trojans do, you may ask, yesterday? Well, the boys basketball and girls soccer traveled to Haskell to play. Both teams lost. Girls soccer lost 0-2, and boys basketball lost 19-26. Well, we still have another chance, Tetzloff. For sure, we'll get it next time. But I did hear from many people that both teams played great. Well, nice try. That's it for today, folks. Back to you, Andres.
It's time to test your knowledge with today's Daily 411.
When was the U.S. Secret Service first established? 1865, 1890, 1900, or 1915? Take five. I think 1915. Well, I think 1895. Oh, it's... Dang. Wait, is the Secret Service the people that...
Isn't it the people that protect the president? Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, visit our website to watch today's broadcast at www.liveandfiveshow.com. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and all those other things.
That's the end of today's show. We'll see you back here Monday morning.